This is Julissa attempting to go through the handicapped doors at the University of the District of Columbia. This is an example of how things...
I don't know what this is.
Just imagine if you were handicapped and you have nobody here to help you and you have to try to open the door by yourself. Do you see how difficult this is? How fair is that to disabled people in America? We are now going to the Disability Center where they have the information for handicapped people and physically and mentally. Let's hope this door works. This is the Disabilities.
Hello, how you doing?
Good. I'm fine. How are you? How may I help you?
Yes, I need to fill out papers to get accommodations as far as me taking my test.
Okay, have you registered with our office?
No.
So you would need to set up a time to meet with Dr. Shanshaw, who would be your intake counselor, and I can give you her card. She's not in the office today.
Okay.
And I can also, here's her
card.
You're welcome. I can also give you the packet that she's going to have you fill out, but also... This is our brochure that tells you all the services that we offer.
All right.
Here, so she is scheduled to be in on Monday.
Okay.
So you can feel free to give her a call, come back by the office, and we'll be more than happy to help you.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome so much, and have a wonderful weekend.
You too.
We are going to the library to the fifth floor where they have the Disability Learning Center. And as you can see, while we're trying to get inside, she cannot get inside the door. And this area here is kind of steep. So good luck to her.
Action.
This is the Learning Resource Division at the school. And as you can see, this door doesn't work either. So she has to try to struggle to get inside. We're going to go straight to the Resource Center for the Blind. Nobody at the reference desk. I got that on video. Nobody at the circulation desk. Not a soul in sight. So what do we do now?
Where exactly is where you go when you're blind or you're deaf and you need to put your paper into the little thing? I'm not sure exactly what it's called.
It's a machine all the way in the back.
To the left?
Uh-huh.
Okay, we're doing a project, so that's why.
Okay.
We're basically trying to, like, do videos.
Yeah, it's a machine Okay, if you go right, you see straight ahead?
Mm-hmm.
And you go to the left, you will see it.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
This computer screen here is for people that are visually impaired, and Julissa is going to demonstrate us on how they use it. As you can see, the small print here, and then once you put it underneath here, it makes it bigger for you so you can read it, and you can adjust the focus and the brightness on it too. And if you're colorblind, you can change the screen itself. Bingo. That's it. And it used for books too. And it has a little pen light on it also in case you lose your word. And she just turned it off. And that adjusts the brightness, and that's for colorblind people.
Here we are at American, going to go check out their disability support services. And here Aubrey is going to attempt to, well, we see on the door they're closed. Well, guess we got here a little bit late. But here at American University is located Disability Support Service 206, Building Mary McGarrett. Here we are on American, and Aubrey is going to attempt to find entrance into this building, which has steps in front of the building. So we're not quite sure how you get into the building. Here they're telling Aubrey that the handicap entrance is right around the corner. And now they're going to show her the entrance into the building.
Yeah, so it has a lock.
Oh no!
Yeah, I don't know.
Now the building is locked.
Well, how do people in a wheelchair like me get in here, in this building?
Usually, if there's a student in a wheelchair in a class in this building, they'll just move it to another building, I think.
Oh, or maybe they give them a key, right?
Or that, I don't know. I'm not sure how it works. I think they just don't want, you know,
people just randomly using it.
Yeah, and breaking
it. I wonder if I can talk to
them. Here we are at American University. And here you see the steps in front of the building. But over here to the right, there's a ramp in which Aubrey is walking and coming up. And here you have more steps. But over to the right, there's a ramp for those who may be in wheelchairs. So there you see it, that here at American University, there are accommodations for students who are in wheelchairs. There may be steps in front of the building, but also to the side, they do have ramps for people in wheelchairs.